Once upon a time, not long ago, not far away, we were near the farm on a snowy day. Nice day, sunny day. Oh, look at that. You know whose car that is? The twins' grandmother. She likes to visit, and they like to have her come and visit. They'll be excited when they get home from school because their grandmother always brings one of her old dolls. She has a whole collection of old, old dolls and everything that goes with them. Sometimes in the summer she'll bring a little doll carriage. Maybe in the winter she brings a sleigh. And they like to see her come. There's that big loop. Now look up, way up. And we're on our way to the castle. I'll hurry over first and go in the back door so I can let the drawbridge down and open the big front doors for you. Are you ready? Here's my castle.
She'll be coming around the mountain. Everybody will be coming around the mountain.
What?
George. I was just remembering and thinking back.
Thinking back and reminiscing. Don't you remember we said that today's the day we read the first book we ever read?
Get the good night moon. Okay.
And here's the very first one we ever read. Here it comes again.
Good night moon.
Good night moon.
Margaret Wise Brown.
I like this one.
Good night, little chairs and furniture way down there.
Oh, that's right. Good night. Good night, stones.
Good night, window.
Good night, girls.
Good night, harp.
Friendly
hand. Good night,
book bag.
Good night, rest.
Good night. Good night.
Wait. The chair was waiting for one of you.
And the rocking chair for another who likes to rock. Big armchair for two more to curl up in when you're coming into our castle. I'll close the big front door and pull up the drawbridge after you're gone. Goodbye. Goodbye. Here's a song that isn't quite a noise.
No.
Well, that's fun to think of words that are... They try to sound like what they're describing.
That's right.
So that if you say them out loud, they sound like the thing.
Goodbye.
Bye-bye, friendly.
Bye, Rusty.
Bye-bye, friendly.
Good night. A little chair will be waiting for one of you. And a rocking chair for another would like to rock. A big armchair for two more to curl up in when you come again to our castle. Now I'll close the front doors and pull up the drawbridge after you've gone. Bye.
Thank you.
Saturday. Welcome to the Saturday Treasure House. Well, I've been telling you in the weekday Treasure House. This is the day. We've let things slide a little bit. Not a little too far. Gotta do a little cleanup job here in the Treasure House today.
It's Saturday and work. Clean up the Treasure House.
Who's going to do a little bit of magic for us right now. Look at that magic hat. What's he going to make appear? We'll be seeing you in the Treasure House. Be kind to each other. Share what you have to share. And do remember your prayers, huh?
What sort of adventure awaited him? Henry was impatient. Come on, Simon, you have some more of your unfinished drawings to complete. The leader is not a school. Follow the leader is a game. You don't have to go to school to learn how to play follow the leader.
Yeah, that's what most people think. But it's not so simple. I mean, it's not easy to get people to follow you till you know how.
And I suppose you know how.
That's why I got an A. You know what the secret is? Anybody around? The hat.
The hat?
The hat.
What could the hat possibly have to do with people following you?
Everything. When I wear this hat, people follow me wherever I go. Just can't help it. I mean, not only people, but things. Yesterday, would you believe, my teacher's desk followed me home.
That's ridiculous.
And then the teacher.
That's ridiculous.
Why don't you try it?
I wouldn't...
Sure. So it's easy to scoff.
All right, look, I'll show you. I'll prove it to you, right?
Okay. Just try it.
Okay, all right. Now, you got the hat on?
Right. Look,
there isn't even anybody around here to follow me.
You just try it. They'll follow.
Okay, I'll walk and see if anybody follows me.
Okay.
Watch. Anybody following me? No, nobody.
Oh, Captain, they just won't follow anybody. You're a born leader.
Police messages. Hello.
We'll join the fun in Raggedy Ann's dollhouse with color forms. Open a door, sweep a floor, we'll play house with color forms. You make dinner, I'll make the bed for Raggedy Andy, sweet dreams, sleepy head. There's lots of pretending to do in Raggedy Ann's dollhouse from color forms.
Raggedy Ann's dollhouse comes with 55 color forms plastic playing pieces.
It's color forms fun.
Gold!
Diamonds!
Great four-folded gold!
That's gold and sugar on Super Sugar Crisp. It's not a treasure.
It isn't?
It's a treat. And Super Sugar Crisp is part of a balanced breakfast.
It's a treat!
What's that?
A Sugar Bear bike reflector. You just snap it together and pop it on your spokes.
Sugar Bear bike reflectors come in 9 different color combinations. One in each specially marked box of Post Super Sugar Crisp cereal.
It's Kenner's Betty Crocker Easy Bake Oven. Light bulbs not included.
Easy bake, mixing, mixing. I'm gonna bake a chocolate cake. Easy bake, watching, watching. Smells so good when I watch it bake. Easy bake, icing, icing. It's a Betty Crocker cake. Fun to bake, for goodness sake. What a treat, fun to eat. Easy bake,
Betty Crocker Easy Bake Oven with mixes from Kenner.
Let's go out to the captain's place.
A friend of mine needed a house, so I made a house for my friend. I'm going to give it to Mrs. Mouse, actually. There's no secret about it. It's a shoebox, and I just cut some holes in the shoebox, and there's a nice one-story house. But it really didn't look right to me, even with the ice cream sticks cut and taped on the back for windows, and the doorway cut and decorated with construction paper. And that's what the shutters are, construction paper. So I thought I'd put a roof on the house. So I took the top of the shoebox and I put a corrugated cardboard box over it to make a roof on the top, like so. And then, because Mrs. Mouse loves the warmth of a fireplace, I had to give her a chimney to go with her fireplace. And that's a nice house for a mouse.
In a lopsided ramshackle bus, we ride from day to day.
You bet.
best.
What does it do?
I don't know. I'm not quite sure yet, but I think it's going to really be a big one.
Oh,
watch
boy.
This now. Put these right in here like that. Now, if you will please turn the machine on. There's a button there. It says on.
Okay. Is it going to grind those carrot greens up?
No, not exactly. Let's watch and see what happens.
What's it doing now?
Freddy's just making a lot of noise.
Hi.
What's that? He won't tell me. It must be a secret of some kind.
No, it's not a secret. If I told him what it's supposed to do and it doesn't work, then he'll be disappointed. I'm not going to tell anybody.
Sounds like a sewing machine.
Are you sewing the carrot greens together?
Well, let's just say, in a way. Done. Take a look. Open this, please.
What? What's that?
A jacket.
A jacket?
Uh-huh.
Kind of small, isn't it?
Not for you. It's for Bunny Rabbit.
That's really made from carrot greens?
Absolutely. Let's see if it fits a bun.
Boy, that's amazing.
Bunny. Boy, you can say that again.
That's amazing.
Carrot greens into cloth. Boy, that's amazing.
Yeah. Listen, I wonder if that machine can make green jeans.
I don't know, but we can ask Mr. Green Jean.
How do you like it? Looks very good. You know what? I made that cloth from carrot greens.
Wow, it looks very good on you, Bunny Rabbit.
You like it?
Mm-hmm.
Listen, I wish you'd wear it for about 2 weeks, say, every day. We'll see how it holds up under ordinary wear and tear, okay?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
2 weeks? Hey, you can't wait 2 weeks to tell the world about this invention.
Well, I have to test the cloth to make sure it's all right.
All right, all right. It's beautiful. Could you make me a jacket like Bunny's?
I think so.
Could you make one for me, too, please?
Guess so.
And make one for yourself. I have an idea.
What's your idea?
You'll find out. You just make the jacket.
And jeans.
Huh?
Could it make green jeans?
I guess so.
Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy. You just make them. This is really going to be big. Big. Big.
How do you think we look, Captain?
We look terrific. That's how we look. You know what we can call this? We can call it greenware.
Yeah, greenware. I like it. I like it. I like it.
Greenware.
You look like the Notre Dame backfield.
I think we really look great. I'll tell you that. We look absolutely great.
Who are you calling, Captain Greenaroo?
Greenaroo. How about that? Miss Frog, would you get me Phil Donahue, please?
Phil Donahue?
That's right. Phil Donahue. Yeah, this is Captain Captain Kangaroo calling.
My grandfather's clock was too large for the shell, so it stood 90 years on the floor. It was taller by far than the old man himself, though it weighed not a single pound. It was bumped on the morn of the day that he was born, and was always his treasure and pride. But it stopped short, never to go again, when the old man died. The old clock looked down on the first step he took as he left my great-grandmother's arms. It watched over him when he read his first book, and he saw his first love and her charm. Through his laughter and tears, it kept pulling off the years, and his proud voice was heard far and wide. But it stopped short, never to go again, when the old man died. Swing to and fro, many hours had he watched as a boy, while the clock ticked along, never fast, never slow, till one day it ran wild in his joy. For it struck 24 when he entered at the door with a blushing and beautiful bride. But it stopped short, never to go again, when the old man died.
Now, folks, we've had many requests from the youngsters in our audience to repeat this next big hit of this past year.
witch doctor, I was in love with you. And then the witch doctor, he told me what to do. He said that.
I owe my soul to the company store.